I could move to LA and try to make it over there, but I decided to stay in San Francisco because I think there's a lot more people that really enjoy acting and the craft for acting, not necessarily because it's gonna get them somewhere as, you know, in their career. It's more about the love for it. I more care about just continuing being creative. You know, if it's not in acting, it's in photography. I just have to do something that will be in a creative form. One of my biggest inspiration was the show Fame that came out, I think it was like 89. And I just wanted to be like those guys. I wanted to sing, I wanted to dance, I wanted to act. And that show really what was true inspiration to, you know, for where I am today.
I have no choice.
But if I don't have this job, I have to leave the country. Maybe there's something else for me to, anything.
You're on an H-1 visa. That's for professionals. I cannot have you in the mailroom. I'm sorry.
Growing up, my dad used to force me to watch all these like old musicals like The Sound of Music and West Side Story and, you know, Seven Brothers to Seven Wives. And, you know, I just, Gene Kelly, I mean, Singing in the Rain, I mean, I watched them all. And West Side Story was probably one of my favorite musicals from all of them. And it was interesting enough because it was the first show I ever did.
You see?
This will be easier if you say it. Very fast.
There was a fight. And somehow a knife and Nadlum. And someone and Nadlum.
Tony. What happened to Tony? She don't tell me. Just told me all night.
He killed your brother!
If I don't get a role, I don't take it personally. I don't. It's, I wasn't right for the part. I went to ACT for about a year. I took about 3 acting classes and a couple voice lessons and stuff like that. But I haven't gone on audition. I was too scared to go and audition, and I've tried it once and I was just terrified. So for like 2 years, 2-3 years, I after school I was like, I haven't done anything. And then I just told myself, look, if you're gonna do it, you have to do it. If you're not gonna do it now, you are not gonna do it. That's where my friend Julie came into the picture. Julie was an actress. She was doing plays and musicals. And she was just doing Into the Woods at Foothill. And she said, look, why don't you come and look at the rehearsal process and see if it's something that you enjoy. And I just remember watching them and I just like fell in love with it. I fell in love with watching them, you know, making it from just a craft of nothing to suddenly a play, a musical. And Julie has always been my inspiration. She was very supportive in everything I've done, and I owe her big time, definitely.
Fired with fire.
Between Places was an interesting role. For me, it was a role that needed to be, that I needed to be part of. And I was happy that I was cast in this role because it was a story of a young man who, you know, come here just like myself for better opportunities to, you know, so he can, well, in his case, like to help his family and all that. He was a very smart guy. He, you know, he was a computer engineer, and the fact that he was an Egyptian Muslim gay, and me playing it as an Israeli, was great because it was a challenge. And I, you know, I have a few Arab friends, and you know, I spoke with them about their life of what it's like to be a Muslim, because being Jewish and being Muslim, it's very, there's some similarity, but some, it's very different because I didn't grow up religious. But also knowing that my brothers would never approve of it since they're very religious, it was, I needed to do this role. I definitely needed to do it.
Gay people.
It's not allowed.
But does it happen?
Of course.
Did you ever do anything like that?
I'm not used to talking about this.
Doesn't that suck?
That everyone doesn't always get to say everything they want?
Yeah, that, you know? And those Islamic countries are so oppressive.
Interests of the whole society are more important in an Islamic country.
Well, I always felt that my sexuality shouldn't become part of who I am as an actor. I feel that, yeah, I came here and, you know, and I was dating girls for a while, and, you know, and then I did it after dating guys, I still went back to dating girls. I don't want to come across as the gay actor. I wouldn't mind playing another gay role. I mean, that's not a problem at all, but I want to be able to play other roles without being typecast. My dad was a photographer. He used to live in a kibbutz, and he was a kibbutz photographer. So I was always around it, but he is, you know, like darkroom and stuff like that. I don't know anything about it. And once digital photography came into place, it was just easier to do. And I took a few photos, and some people thought, you know, the photos were really good, and I have a good eye, and I should continue doing what I do. I just know what grabs my attention, and that's what I usually photograph. In the next few years, I probably want to just focus on photography when I have more time. I have actually some display of my work that's going to happen in December. With film, I'm getting back into it because I took a long break. I took about a year and a half, 2 years of a break. So getting back into it, and I want to continue doing it. The great John Wolfgang von Goethe said before, in the moment of commitment, the entire universe conspired to assist you. And I so believe it's true, because everything that I've done in my life, if I put 100% into it, I got it, you know? But you really have to allow yourself to be there. You know, that's why I don't have it in me to go to LA and live the starving artist life. I don't. That's why probably I'm not there. But I have it in me to get things I want here.